there's one other problem I want to do called a pulley problem. This doesn't involve any new forces, but it is on homework number 5 because it's an application of the forces we have, but kind of synthesized in a new way. So there's a lot we can do with the forces we have. The way I'm going to approach this is by doing an example, and then when I need a kind of a trick or something involving pulleys that I haven't talked about, I'll just bring it off to the side and introduce it to you, and then we'll use it right away. So here we go. Here we have a pulley. I'm going to drape a rope over it. I'm going to attach a mass to either end. And the givens in this problem are those two masses, M1 and M2. Givens, of course, I usually mark with a question mark. That's how I label them. So kind of keep the alphabet soup kind of a little bit manageable. I'm going to say that the pulley doesn't really introduce a whole lot to the system. The string and the pulley are both massless. So they don't have any inertia of their own. In fact, the only purpose that the pulley is going to serve is to redirect the rope. Okay, so it's a way of redirecting the rope up and over and connecting it to another mass. Here's what I'm going to ask. I'm going to ask for the acceleration of each, I'll put it like this, the acceleration of each mass. So A1 and A2. And those generally, ask is question mark, givens are check mark. Sorry, didn't mean to confuse you there. And believe it or not, if we walk through this carefully and use a few tricks, we can actually solve the problem. So let's go ahead and do it. 6-step plan. We'll probably get a few of these steps done because a few of the steps are really easy. Step 1, object of interest. Well, here we have 2, right? So I'm going to focus in on this mass because I want to know its acceleration. I'm also going to have to focus in on this mass because I want its acceleration. Step 1, done. Step 2, identify the forces that act on that. Well, we have the force of gravity is going to pull down on each one of these. And, of course, there's going to be a string attached to each one. So, remember, tension always pulls, never pushes. So, we make sure that it pulls. Okay, the tension points away from the object. Okay, step 2, done. Step 3, choose some axes. We want to choose an axis in the direction of along the acceleration. And here, I'll go ahead and choose the y direction like that, because then my accelerations are going to be along that axis, right? Either a plus or minus, but the one of mass might go up, the other one's going to go down, but they're all on that. That's step 3 taken care of. Step 4, break into components. Check. Done with that. There's nothing to do. This is a one-dimensional problem. There's no diagonal forces involved. Okay? So, on to step 5. So step 5 was to write down an x equation and a y equation for an object. Not a little twist here. We don't have an x equation, but we do have a y equation for two objects. So let's write those down here real quick. And then we'll pick up. So I'm going to write down a y equation. I should probably, just to keep them straight, this is for object 1, 1, 1, 2, 2, 2. Both of them have an up force from the tension and a downward force from gravity. Same thing over here. So there we have it. Those are the equations for each mass, and it's going to take some math and some tricks to sort out the two accelerations. I'll show you those next time. So we'll pick up with the final step 6 of this pulley problem on Monday. Again, this is not, though, on your homework 4. So